What's going on, YouTube? It's your boy Cameron, back at it again with a Black Ops Cold War video. And guys, Nuketown 84 is live today, along with some double weapon XP and some double XP, so you can hit that Prestige Master quicker than ever, and you can level up your guns to level 55. But Nuketown is back with some cool new features and some bad new shit going on. The cool new shit is the look. The look looks sick as fuck. It's pretty much Black Ops 1 Nuketown, you know? Like, it's Nuketown. It's been the same since Black Ops 1, since 10 years ago. And I think it's pretty cool. I like the look of this Nuketown. It's not too different, like, you know, layout-wise. Like, every Nuketown kind of has a differentiation with the layout, kind of. Like, you have OG Nuketown, which is, like, the, you know, the pristine look. Then you got Nuketown 2025 or whatever, and that was a kind of futuristic neighborhood look. And then you have Black Ops 3's, which in my opinion is garbage. That is the worst Nuketown with the whole like acid look that game was going for. And then you have Black Ops 4, which is like the snowy look. And now you have this decrepit like sandstorm look, which is pretty cool. I actually really like the look. There's graffiti everywhere, there's sand everywhere, it looks unkept, it looks like there hasn't really been anybody there in years, because as you guys know, like Nuketown is based off of the fake towns they used to have in the 40s, 50s, and 60s when they used to test nukes and blow that shit up, and now it's all decrepit. I don't know how accurate it would be. They probably wouldn't let people in that area because there's hell radiation and you'd die and get cancer and shit, but it's pretty cool, man. I like the artwork. There's, you know, graffiti everywhere. There's like a bunch of anti-war graffiti and stuff there, and it's really cool, man. The look is really, really sick. I really enjoy it. The layout is exactly the same. Three lanes, tiny ass map, chaos. Yeah, it looks great, man. Honestly, it looks good. It's fun. The game is fun, dude. Nuketown is pretty fun, especially when you get a casual ass lobby, not the sweat fest. It's pretty fun, dude. Like, it's just chaos. I think Nuketown is the best small map in Call of Duty history. I think Nuketown is much better than Shipment, and I think Nuketown is much better than Rust. And the recent iterations are testament to that. You know, Rust and Shipment and Modern Snorefare were horrible. You were pretty much at the mercy of the spawn system in those maps. And then this map, yeah, Nuketown has some questionable spawns. I'm not going to sit here and be like, yeah, dude, the spawns in Nuketown are sick as fuck. It's pretty easy to get spawn trapped in Nuketown, as it always was. Like, if you get spawn trapped in Nuketown, it's game over. And that's always been the issue with the map, and why a lot of people don't really like it. But I don't mind it, bro, because I'm usually the person doing the spawn trapping, you know. And people don't like Nuketown because you can just head glitch and camp in the fucking second story room and just shit on everybody. I'm not gonna lie, I do that too. I'm a scumbag when I play Nuketown. But the thing is, you kinda have to be. When you play these tiny ass maps that are just so chaotic and everything is going to shit around you, you can't just be like being all retarded and just running around like an idiot. Like, you kinda have to like calculate it a little bit more. So, I don't know. Nuketown is a lot of fun, man. I'm having a lot of fun on Nuketown today. I got like 3 or 4 chopper gunners today in Nuketown, and it was really sick, man. The action is there. And this is definitely the best map of the game. Hundo P, it is the most fun map in the game. You can just get a bunch of kills. You can get a bunch of camos. You can, it has double weapon XP, so you can grind up your levels, because a big issue in this game is how long it takes to grind up your levels for your guns. I don't really care about the XP for, like, you know, prestige and stuff, but I did hit second prestige, but I don't really care about that. I just care about how long it takes to get attachments, man. It takes forever to get attachments in this game, and I just like how the double weapon XP is here. It's also in zombies, by the way, guys. The zombies is here, so if you want to grind out your guns in zombies, you can go there too. But I'm just glad the double weapon XP is here, bro. That shit is needed. I definitely need to get these cheese attachments at the end of the road for some of these guns, for sure. I think for my tactical rifles, I'm all pretty much have the best attachments. I have the barrels that increase the damage and the fire rate, and those are definitely the best barrel for the AUG and the M16. But I'm still trying to level up the automatic guns, because I feel like the assault rifles are kind of meh this year. My favorite's definitely that QBZ, but like the M4 and the fucking FAMAS is garbage. The Krieg is pretty good. And the AK. Yeah, what the hell am I talking about? The AK is OP as well. But, dude, Nuketown is sick. Back to Nuketown. Nuketown is sick, man. Like, I don't want to be sound recency biased or anything like that, but Nuketown is a lot of fun. It is definitely the best map in this game. You guys should definitely go try it out. Like, it's fucking insane, dude. Nuketown is a lot of fun, bro. Like, yeah, the bad is the skill-based matchmaking in it, and there are still some sweaty fucking shit lobbies. But I was partied up today, and I was playing with my friends, and we all have differentiating KDs, so I think that's the best way around the algorithm, is to party up and play with people who have different stats and different KDs all along the spectrum, because then you get more random lobbies, and I was enjoying that. Like, you had a couple good players on the team, or you had one or two good players, like one average guy and like a bunch of ass guys. Like, I think that was more like OG Call of Duty. You had like the couple good players on the other team and some okay players and some ass players, because the randomness was what made it fun. And I think when I was playing, that was the experience I got. It felt like fun. It didn't feel like a fucking CDL tournament. Granted, in this gameplay, I'm not partied up at all, so it is pretty sweaty, and there was a lot of people bunny hopping and shit. I mean, I was camping like a bitch in this goddamn room and taking people out, but still, man, it was a lot of fun, dude. Nuketown is live. It's pretty sweet. I'm enjoying it. What do you guys think about Nuketown? Do you like it? And where does it rank on all the Nuketowns for you? I'm gonna rank all my Nuketowns right now. I think, nostalgia boner aside, the best Nuketown is the OG Black Ops 1 Nuketown. That one is just a classic, bro. I don't think that one's ever gonna get surpassed. The look of like the pristine like neighborhood, and you have some Area 51 action on the outskirts, and you have the little RCXD glitch. I don't even know if that's here. Is the RCXD like secret path still in Nuketown? Because that was really cool. I remember in Black Ops 1 you had the little secret path you could take with the RCXD, where you could go outside the map and could end up in the enemy spawn and like kill everybody when they spawned. I remember that was a huge thing, and that was really, really cool. I liked that shit a lot. It was a lot of fun to see that. But I don't know, man. Like, this Nuketown, I don't know. I really like Black Ops 2's Nuketown as well. I like the whole, like, futuristic neighborhood look and how just weird it looks. And how it just looks cool. Like, you have, like, a futuristic, like, 50s in, like, I don't know. Like, the car has, like, a 1950s, like, look, but it's all futuristic. It's, like some Leroy Jetson action or some shit. It's pretty dope. You know, you got some Jetson action, and, like, that's the way it looks, and Black Ops 2 Nuketown may be the second. And then I'm going to go this Nuketown. I think this Nuketown is definitely the third best Nuketown. Just the look looks really cool. I like the graffiti. I like the whole decrepit, arid look. It's really cool. Then Black Ops 4, the snowy look is pretty cool. There are just too many mannequins everywhere in Black Ops 4, and that can get kind of annoying, but definitely then Black Ops 4. All four of those are good maps, all right? Every single one of those is a good map. They're all super fun, and I enjoy them a lot. Black Ops 1, 2, Cold War, and Black Ops 4 both have a dope-ass Nuketown. They're all fun as fuck to play. The only one that's shit is Black Ops 3. Black Ops 3's Nuketown is fucking ass. I hate Black Ops 3 Nuketown. That map is garbage in Black Ops 3, just with the advanced movement and everything. It just didn't work. It just did not work in that game. It was trash. Black Ops 3 Nuketown is by far the worst Nuketown I have ever played. I hate that Nuketown. That Nuketown is garbage. But the other four, good times. But that's my Nuketown, man. Like, the mannequins on this one can get a little annoying because the player visibility is already trash. But it doesn't matter to me, bro. Like, it's still fun. Like, I like it, bro. I mean, I might change when I get hit with more of the sweaty-based matchmaking. I did get hit with, like, 3 or 4 sweaty-ass games. Actually, the one I got my chopper gunner in was a sweat fest. I don't know how the hell I did so well in that game. But there it is, man. Like, it was fun. Nuketown is good. I like it. Keep content like this coming. Let me know what you guys think about Nuketown in the comment section below. That all being said, this is your boy Cameron. Thank you all for watching. I am out.